Morgan. I'm Church Lady's Church Chat. You know, I know sometimes I have guests on my show, but this time I'm going to have a little female right over here. Dear Church Lady, I watch your show from time to time, and I think the show has no point whatsoever. Well, I also think you are so obnoxious and rude. Well, isn't that special? You are crazy. Signed, Kill Church Lady. Well, Mr. Kill Church Lady, if I'm really crazy, let me blow up right now. I'm still here. Let's think now. What could have urged him on to write that little letter to me? What could have urged him just to go that extra mile? I just don't know who. Could it be, maybe, Satan? Next letter. Dear Church Lady, last Sunday my boyfriend's grandmother slipped in the shower and she hit her head on the tub. Well, isn't it a coincidence it happened on a Sunday? He needed my help. I missed Mass for the first time in 13 years. Well, apparently someone at school church when it's convenient. Let's think now. What could they have possibly been doing in a hot, steamy room? Their naughty parts were probably engorged and ding-ding saying, take me, take me, take me. Her buttocks were probably gyrating to the delight of that little boyfriend. Her back was probably arched so her nipples tip up just a wee little bit. And his sexual organ in the lower abdominal area was probably stiffening ever so slightly. Then I guess the grandmother just woke up. How convenient. People, these are trying times. Everybody's trying things. I'm getting caught. So people, when you go out into that big world of yours, let me just say that I'm just a wee bit superior to all of thee. Bye-bye now.
Out there.
Well,
There's the police! Come out with your hands up!
I know where I can see him. Give me some bail! Thank you for watching Lifestyles of the Rich and Famous. Excuse me. That's Lifestyles of Lovers and Muggers. Join me tomorrow when our guest will be Israel Ramirez. He is known for killing his wife, his daughter, and his kid, two kids. By accident. Ha ha ha. Thank you. Goodbye. Have a good day. Ha ha. Wishing you champagne wishes and caviar dreams.
These kids have been the most neglected children since the 60s, 70s, and 80s. Now, with our quick cameraman, we get a chance to interview one of these diseased children. Meet Francie.
I like grape jello. I really do. It's really good. It's good. It tastes like grapes. Babe Ruth makes the last catch in the 1997 World Series against the Philadelphia Giants. You know what? I like grape jello. It's really good. It is. I don't know. It's really good. Let me see. This is apple, I think. No, it's a peach. It's a pineapple. I like grape jello. I really do. It's a pillow. Yellow pillow. How now, brown cat? I like grape jello. I do. And goodbye. Grape jello.
That was Francie. He doesn't know what's around him or what will be around him. But he does know that life will come slowly for a diseased child, for he is diseased. The end is near for our poor Francie. Special update. We've just been notified that two more diseased children have been found in South Ozone Park, Queens. They're said now to be in psychiatric help. But let's keep an eye out for these children. They don't know what's happening.
Well, it's time for the box. Video music box. With the ever popular word segment.
Word.
I'm DJ Ralph McDaniels.
And I'm the Vid Kid. And due to an unsuccessful experiment, Run DMC, they turn white, as white as milk. You get that, y'all? And here's their new hit single,
Hit It Run.
Wanna rock around the clock? You can't say I'm not. And in case you forgot, I'm the king.
Hot.
won't rob, but our job is to get paid.
Segment of the box,
video music box. I'm DJ Ralph McDaniels.
And I'm the Vid Kid.
Until tomorrow, my friends. Word.
I'm John Houston. And I have emphysema. Take care of your lungs. It's a matter of life and breath.
Oh, hello. I'm the late Yul Brynner, and I'm here to tell you something about scalp care. Nothing more than I like to go out on vacation and keep my scalp nice and neat. So I use a comb, and I use stiff scalp hairspray. It keeps my scalp nice and stiff. So for people like Mr. Olson and myself, please use stiff scalp. It keeps your scalp nice and neat. Thank you, and have a good day.
Clifford B. Warren, the cameraman, will be on a search for a distinct person close to the Bigfoot ages. His species is called Spuds, and his name is Paul Bone. We will be looking through the jungles of Queens for this distinct animal. I have to go now. Search for this animal. Goodbye.
I'm here with my camera searching for that pole person. I left to look very hard. He's somewhere around here. Last year my cameraman saw him around here somewhere. So he should be around here somewhere. Oh my god, it's him! Hold on, back it up, Steve, back it up, it's him, I see him, he's right there. That's him, all right. That's him. Keep it back. He's dangerous. That's him, all right. We can tell that it's him. We can tell by those Converse sneakers with no socks. Yes, it's him. All right. Everyone, be quiet now. Don't move. He's very dangerous. Those Converse sneakers are very harmful. We can also tell it's him by that patch in the... by that hole in the pants. It's him, all right. Yeah, look at that hole. It's him. That hand, that's... oh, God, it's terrorizing. Look at that. That's him, all right. Oh, my God. Come on. Back it up. He looks like he's getting mad. Jeez. No, don't. Oh my god. Oh my god, hurry! Steve! Steve, get us out of here! Steve, he's coming after Steve! Oh my god, Steve!
Oh, great!
Steve, back up, Steve! Steve, he's coming! Oh my god, Steve!
The couch you are sitting. Roll.
I see Jerry race down her spine.
Thank you. student. This is 13337 130th Street.
Yeah?
Joe's Pizza.
Alright, thanks.
Take care now. Enjoy that pizza.
Thanks.
Goodbye.
Sneakers you got me, but I wanted Adidas.
I'm sorry, son.
No, that's okay.
So I have some bad news to tell you.
What?
I can't afford to send you to college.
Why not?
Your mother's always at work. I need someone here to cook. I could use a nice slice of pizza now and then.
I wish I was black! Support the United Hockey College Fund, because the mind is a terrible thing to waste. Goodbye.
Support the United Hockey College Fund, because the mind is a terrible thing to waste.
Bullied by your shampoo.
Bullied.
Hello there. You're probably wondering who I am. But I'm Frank Perdue. And I'm here to tell you about one of my new products. First there was the oven stuffer roaster, and then there was the boneless chicken. But now it's my new invention. Wingless flies. Buy them by the dozen or buy them by the economy pack. And if you're wondering why I'm going to new heights for you people, well, who knows?
Honey, come in to eat!
Wait a minute!
Come on, honey, it's getting cold!
Wait a minute! A five-letter word for thought.
Come on, it's coming to eat!
Wait a minute! How am I supposed to think when you're bothering me like this? Yeah.
Michael Jackson from the Apollo Theater. Let's y'all give him a good hand now.
Clifford B. Warren once quoted with saying, "The United States of America is the greatest country to live in." And even in the greatest country to live in, there comes disgusting parts. And here are the closest and glimpses of the disgusting parts of the United States.
We're sneaking in on young scholar Michael Warchola getting ready for a day of school at St. Francis Preparatory.
Oh, I have the zit on my face. Ow. Oh, that feels much better.
Now we have a glimpse of Michael Dukakis and his most disgusting moment in history.
My fellow Americans, as your president, I will cut the tax deficit. Excuse me, I'm sorry. And raise low-income tax and everything else. Thank you.
Another moment in history. A father changing his newborn son for the first time.
Yeah, homeboy, you like my fresh ring?
Yeah, I like it a lot.
Ow, man! Ow! Oh, man, get my ring! Get my ring!
And that includes an average day for a white man in Harlem.
And that concludes our report on America's most disgusting moments. I'm John Bozzamato. Good night.
Okay, one last time. This is drugs. That's your brain on drugs. Any questions?
Yeah, I got a question.
Shut up, idiot. You ruin it.
One side of the world, a man feels a shock at that exact same moment. His brother screams as he touches a hot pan. Ouch!
It's dismissed as coincidence.
By Time Magazine. Because this series tells us about our untapped mysteries of the mind. For example,
one side of the world, a young boy is picking his nose.
Ah, oh, yeah.
And on the other side of the world, the man is eating it. But it's dismissed as chance. On the other side of the world, a boy is playing with his computer. But on the other side of the world, the computer is playing with the boy. But it is dismissed as
piano, but even better, I like playing the organ. Well, you know what kind of organ I mean. Well, I got to go now. Bye-bye.
Welcome to A Current Affair. Our topic for tonight, nerds. Are nerds taking over America? I had the chance to interview one of these nerds. Meet Oscar. Oscar, thanks for coming.
Well, thank you. It's very pleasant to be in this environment, Maury.
Oscar, is it true that you got over 1,000 on your IQ test?
Yes, I manipulated my brain to undergo very hard questions, therefore permitting me to do good on the IQ test.
Oh, that's very good.
Yes, I know.
You seem to be a bit overweight. Does that interfere with your nerdiness?
Well, I feel that the undergoing of complete metamorphic change at puberty completely changed the way of life. So the answer is no. Oh, negative.
Well, you sure do look like a nerd, with those zits, glasses, ugly pants, greasy hair, and those ugly, disgusting glasses.
I resent that. I should say that I find you revolting, vulgar, and flip. Goodbye.
Hey, well, you'll get something for that. Well, there you have it. I am Mark Polish, signing off for our current affair. Goodbye.
Oh,
jeez.
What's the phone number for 911?
911.
Hold on. I can't hear you. I have to put my glasses on.
911.
Come on, jeez. Hurry up, jeez.
Maybe you know you can get that cast taken off a dream in 6 months.
Don't no kidding, Major.
And do me a favor with you. Feed the dog, please.
Second cookie, he's on for the third cookie, and he's on the third cookie, chewing it, eating it, storing it. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He finished him in 10 seconds. Good for Joseph, yay!
Bye, my friends, it's time to come to an end. Now, next week, my kitties and lovelies, I will show you the victim of the one murderer, Mr. Olson, wanted dead or bald. Now here he is.
Here's a little song I wrote. Might want to sing it note for note. Don't worry. Ho 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 ho. Be happy. Every day we have some trouble, but when you worry, you'll make it double. So don't worry. Be happy. All together now. When you worry, your face will frown, and that will bring everybody down. So don't worry, be happy. Don't worry, be happy. Here, here's my phone number, you call me, I'll be happy. I am very happy.
Hi, I'm Mike Tyson.
I want you to come to the Mike Tyson School of Driving. Yes, I'll teach you how to make right turns. I'll teach you how to make left turns. And by 3 years, you'll be a civilized driver like me, Mike Tyson.
Samurai's Chinese ninja in this house, and I am destined to find it. I know you are in here, so why don't you make yourself seen?
You'll pay for that.
That is what you think.
Now you have made me very mad. We shall fight to the end.
Prepare to die, chink.
Sticks and stones may break my bones, but names will never hurt me.
What may be a dream may also be reality.
Joey, did you do your homework?
Yeah, I only have one more subject to do. I'll do it after dinner.
Now do it, and after you do it, go to bed.
I don't have to listen to you.
Oh, ow.
I hate you. I wish you were dead.
Thank you. Oh, Dad. Oh my God. Dad.
And now it's time for America's TV show, Geraldo Rivera.
Hello everybody, I am Geraldo Rivera, and welcome to the Geraldo Rivera Show. My guest today is Elvis Presley. Now Elvis, what a surprise. Where have you been hiding all these years?
Well, I've been in Africa for 6 years, and in Libya for 5.
Now, I know you've been hiding, but why do you do that to your fans?
Because I heard that the fans have been losing interest in me, because of some newcomer named Liberace. But since recently, my reporters have told me that Liberace had been dead with AIDS, had died. So I decided to come back.
Now I see you've gained weight and you lost some hair color.
Yes, it's that African food. I can't keep away from it.
Well, thank you for being here, Elvis.
Yeah, thanks. No problem.
Well, bye, Elvis. See you later. Well, there you have it, folks. I am Geraldo Rivera signing off for the Geraldo Rivera Show. Bye-bye.
That was the Geraldo Rivera Show, starring Geraldo.
Cameron Steve. The top will hear my Cameron Steve. We're here at the kitchen of the ever-famous restaurant Tung Hung Lo. We're wondering what makes their food so tasty. Excuse me, what's your name?
My name is Wong.
What's your last name?
Wong, but you can call me Double Wong. Come on, why don't you just get out of here? I'm trying to cook tomato dinner. Can't you see? I'm trying to cook tomato dinner, and people aren't letting me cook tomato. Hey, what's the tomato dinner? Tell me that the put you there now. They go tomato dinner.
Well,
you did.
There you have it. I'm Ted Koppel, signing off. Good night.
Do 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 do
do do do do do
Just when you thought it was safe to go out into the street, the Moonies will hassle you once again.
Want a Bible Moon or a Daily News?
Oh my God!
Wanna buy a paper? If you wanna read it, you buy it. Wanna buy the Daily News?
The TV is by Sony. The lamp is by Muhammad. The piano by Baldwin. And the cat food by Fancy Feast. Would you give your cat anything less?
Hello everybody, I am Bob Vila, and once again welcome to This Old House. Today in This Old House, we'll be taking a look at the plumbing. Now let's go into the bathroom. Ah, the bathroom. Now, I know one thing, there's a toilet. Now there's many problems with the toilet. For instance, there's clogging. But I'm gonna give you two ways how to overcome that problem. First, there's the good old plunger. Now, this is how you do it. You stick it in and do this and this and this and this until all the stuff comes out. But I don't like doing it that way. I myself like doing it my own way. Be a man. Stick stick your hand in there. Feel around. I'm sure there's something you can get out. Oh, I feel something, yeah. Oh my god, a sneaker. These people. I thought I saw something else in there. Oh, a giant hairball. Well, that's enough of the toilet. Let's check out this shower. Let me see here. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's good. No, it's good in there. Oh! 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 Well, that's enough of plumbing for today. And now, while my hands are still wet, let's go look at the electrical outlets. Well, wait a second. I gotta change first. Oh. Oh! I've changed! Well, it's great when you can do a camera trick. You can even ask David Copperfield. Now let's go check out the electric. Let me find a good outlet. Oh, there's one. Now, listen closely. Now, this is a bioconducer, which transforms with the electrical current from this one with the wire plug in this one. Oh my gosh. Hey, the light went out. Oh, let's go check the fuse box. It's right down these steps. Okay, come on down. Oh, there you are. Oh, here's the fuse box. Oh, let me see. Oh, that's not it. Ah, here it is.
Oh, great. All the lights went out. Oh, well, I'm Bob Vila signing off for this old house. Goodbye, everybody.
Hello, Bond. James Bond speaking.
Hello, Bond. It's your boss, Q.
Oh, hello, Q. Can I ask you something? How come I haven't got any new missions from you? How come I haven't got any new death-defying travels?
That's just why I've called you, Bond. I have a brand new mission for you. Before I tell you, could you come down to the warehouse and take a look at the weapons I've constructed for you?
Sure, Q. I'll be right over.
I worked up for you for your next mission.
Okay.
Now this looks like an ordinary calculator, but obviously it isn't. A telephonic computer.
Ooh.
You can use it to call me on it or do whatever.
Okay.
Now this looks like an ordinary pen, but of course it isn't. It's a very lethal device.
Ooh.
Point it at any man or woman, press the button, turns them into a homosexual.
Oh.
This looks like an ordinary handkerchief, but if you open it up, spin it around three times, things just disappear.
Whoa.
Don't blow your nose on it.
Okay.
Very careful with that.
And what's this? What's my mission?
Now, this has to do with your next mission.
Oh.
Now, your job is to find...
Oh, Silver Toe?
Guys, name it. And to get You have the disc. That looks exactly like this, Ron.
Oh, and I have to keep this away from you?
Exactly. He's going to do the same thing from you. Make sure he does not get that one.
Okay. Thank you, Q. Take this.
You're welcome. Be very careful with the homosexual device.
I'll see you. Easy money.
Telephonic computer. I have to call Q. Oh, here it is. Oh, hello, Q. Yes, it's James Bond. Hi. You know that telephonic computer you gave me? Yeah, well, you told me how to disappear, but you forgot to tell me how to reappear.
Next time you see Bond, I want you to kill him.
What are you doing here?
We're going to kill you. But first, give me the disc.
No, I can't.
Oh, yes, you can.
All right, you defeated me. Here.
Now, I would like you to sign this letter saying that we beat you, and then I'll kill you, and then we'll be on our merry way.
So you want me to sign this?
Yes.
Certainly.
I knew you had such big muscles. Come on, let's go home and tell us about old war stories.
Well, looks like I came out on top again. Talking about being on top, I think this is the only James Bond movie I was in that I never had sex with a girl 100 times. But there's another reason why I came out on top. The reason is because I am Bond. James Bond, 007, licensed to kill.
Thank you.
Hello, neighbor. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Won't you be mine? It's a beautiful day for a beauty wood, a beautiful day for a beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I have always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you. So let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, could you be mine? Would you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Please won't you be my neighbor? Hello, neighbor. Let's go into the living room. I have some things to show you. Hello, neighbors. Today we're going to talk about self-inflicted pain. Could you say that? Good. Now, there are many ways you can inflict pain on yourself, and one of these ways is with putting nails through your fingers. It just so happens that I have a nail with me. Now, I'm going to do it. Oh, boy. This looks bad. I better wrap this up with gauze. Here we go. See? It's as easy as that. Just a little blood on it. That's okay. See? Now, another way to inflict pain would be with, razor blades. Yeah, razor blades. Now, this is how we're going to do it. I'm going to take an ordinary razor blade, and I'm going to stick it right in my finger. Okay? Now, let me see if I have a razor blade around here somewhere. Oh, here's one. Here's a razor blade. Perfectly new razor blade. Now, I'm going to do it now.
Ow.
Oh. Okay, here we go. See? And it's as easy as that. Now, if you really knew for some good pain, you could twist it. Like this. But we don't want to get to that deep stuff. Now, another way you could self-inflict pain would probably be with, probably sticking cigarettes in your eyes. So, let me see if I have a nice little cigarette here. But here's one. Okay, now I'm going to do this now. You just watch. You can try this at home. Oh, but now when you put the cigarette away, don't smoke it because smoking it is bad for us. We don't want to hurt our bodies like that. And now, for our next self-infliction procedure, we'll be using... Do I hear something? I think I hear the trolley. Oh, hi, trolley.
What's that?
You want some pain too? Oh, well, okay. What? Okay.
Well, that's enough pain for you, Charlie.
I'll see you, babe. Now, another way of self-inflicting pain would be with the finger guillotine. Now, I'm going to cut my finger off. Put my finger in here, and one, two, three. Oh, ho, ho. Ow! Gee, I cut my finger right off. Okay, well, that's enough of that now. I have to clean this up. What a mess I made on this table here. I have to clean that up. You clean up your amputated body parts and you're done with them? I do. Now, just for one more last self-infliction pain procedure. Well, that's enough self-inflicted pain for today. So I'll be back when the day is new, and I'll have more self-infliction pain ideas for you. And you'll have more amputated body parts to talk about. I will too. Goodbye, everybody.
This has been Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
Mr. Rogers is paid for by the Helena Rubinstein Foundation. Good night, boys and girls.
Hi, I'm from Apex Tech, and I want you to become an Apex Tech employee. And if you're good enough, you can become a graduate. When you start out at Apex Tech, we give you a screwdriver. And if we see that you're a good screwer, we'll give you a hammer. And if we see that you can bang good, we'll give you your very own power screwdriver. So come to Apex Tech and be a great mechanic.
I can't call you, but you can call us at 943-7300. Now I can't call you, but you can call us at 943-7300. I can't do this commercial anymore. How long have we been doing this commercial, huh? About 25 years? And how many people have called us, huh? Two people have called us in the stupid Apex Tech commercial. And you, put that stupid cue card down. I think I've just about know how to say, now I can't call you, but you can call us. And I can't call you, but you call us. Give me a break, I quit.
Hello, my name is Martin Dinkleberry. And a few years ago, a few students at a nearby college put a system together called SAD, Students Against Drunk Driving.
This is a contract you have to sign saying that if I get drunk, you have to come and pick me up, no questions asked.
Okay, son, I'll sign it.
But now, there's a new system put out, and it's made by a totally different group of people, and it's called
RAD, Retards Against Drunk Driving.
This is a contract you have to sign saying that if I get drunk, you have to come and pick me up, no questions asked. Will you please sign it, Daddy?
Okay, I'll sign it for you.
So please support this system. You know why you should support it? Because it's RAD.
Time for my daily shower. Darn, I have a skid mark.
Look, I'm here to talk to you about a problem Americans are suffering from, skid marks. Surveys show that 7 out of 10 people have skid marks. If you happen to be one of those 7, I think you should try
Skid Away.
Yes, only three pills a day will relieve you of those embarrassing skid marks. So buy Skid Away and be happy when you take off your underwear and it's clean.
I hope Skid Away worked! It worked! Get them because they're running out.
on, Duke. What are we gonna do about Boss Hogg? But you know he has been a nuisance. Yeah, he did shoot Uncle Jesse 324 times in the head. Yeah, I think we should kill him, Bo. I think so too. Let's go get the General Lee.
Luke! How is Hodge told you to leave these dang windows open?
Sorry, Bo. I got a question. All these years we've been diving through the windows. Why don't we just open the door?
Hey, Bo, there's Boss Hogg now.
Get the gun, Luke.
All right. You doggone Duke boys better watch for your shooting those guns.
Try the hand grenade.
All right. You doggone Duke boys! World War II is over! No need to throw around no damn grenades!
Darn! It didn't work! There's only one more thing we can do. We're gonna have to hit him with the General Lee!
You darn Duke boys, where'd you ever get?
Oh, and welcome! I'm Mr. January. But tonight, I'm gonna tell you something about my friend, Joey. Because he's here at Chippin' Wales tonight, so let's have a big hand for Joey, Big Joey Tedesco! Kissing. So please, wear a condom. And it's on.
Oh. Hey, it looks like grape jello.
What's up?
I like grape jello.
I like your jello.
We like it jello. We like it jello. We like it jello. We like it jello. We like it jello.
Hello?
Yeah, John.
Right,
bye. Bye-bye.
Dinner's getting ready, folks.
All right.
Like grape jello.
Oh, no, no, please, no, no.
Like grape jello.